Again today, well above 100 degrees in most places, 105 Enid and Stillwater, 102 in Woodward, 106 in Clinton. Again, the heat index, when you factor in the humidity, a lot of places feel anywhere between 105 and 112 up there in Stillwater. As you would expect, the heat advisory is still in effect and goes through tomorrow evening for most of the area, including Oklahoma City. Daytime highs tomorrow won't fall off much. They may nudge down a couple degrees, but it's still going to be a very steamy Sunday for us. This is the severe weather potential right now, mainly in Kansas, but it does skirt northern Oklahoma, including Harper, Woods, Alfalfa, portions of Grant and Kay counties. Now, if you looked at the aerial part of this watch and not just the counties, it would just get south of the border. It doesn't even include all of the county that we're talking about in blue. But what's happening is along this boundary, we're seeing showers and thunderstorms develop. Some of them are going to produce some very gusty downburst winds. Some larger hail is possible. I think most of the activity will stay in southern Kansas. Some of this could slip south of the border. We're seeing a heavier storm near Buffalo right now. The biggest threat out of this storm is going to be some 50, 55 mile an hour winds. Probably not a lot of rain, probably getting eaten away. And we're also watching storms coming out of the Panhandle of Texas, but as I expected, they're also dying down as they get towards Roger Mills and Ellis counties. Those storms aren't severe either. So along that boundary and a little bit to the south, there's a chance for some showers and storms tonight right along the border, perhaps a severe thunderstorm or two. The metro remains dry. It remains warm as we head overnight as well. 75 degrees will start you off at 79 at 8 a.m. under mostly sunny skies. Tomorrow plays out much like it did today. A lot of sunshine and very hot conditions. A high tomorrow right around 100. There is some isolated storms trying to get in here late in the day tomorrow, but it's going to take some time. Lows overnight will mainly be in the low to the mid 70s. Highs tomorrow, it'll be cooler up north, but still triple digits from the metro into the southern part of the state. That front will finally make some progress through the southern part of the state tomorrow. So it's going to bring us a better chance of rain and some cooler weather. Predictors showing you some of those storms again right along the northern part of the state tonight. Then things die out overnight. Then through the afternoon hours tomorrow, scattered showers and thunderstorms. They'll redevelop overnight Monday. Could be a few scattered showers and thunderstorms on Monday afternoon. And that could even carry into Monday night into Tuesday morning. So we're breaking this weather pattern. This front coming through is going to do us a world of good. It's going to give chances of rain for the metro north tomorrow afternoon. And then everyone gets a chance starting tomorrow night. And this will probably be through the afternoon hours of not only Monday, but Monday night as well. So tomorrow night's a real good chance as we head through the overnight hours. And some of that stuff could be some fairly heavy rain. So that's where I think the best chance is. Monday and Tuesday still has some possibilities, but also the temperatures. Real good stuff here, guys. We're back to the low 90s. That's near normal morning lows back into the lower 70s.